Hello guys, welcome back to Chenda DIY. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a lace ruffle top. It's really easy and friendly for beginners. For this top, it can fit for size small and medium because the top have the back tie, so you can adjust the size. But for you guys that make bigger size, I also showing you how to measuring the top on the body. Okay, now let's get into the video. First thing first, I'm gonna show you how to crochet the basic stitches that I'll be using in this tutorial. First, how to make slip stitch. To make slip stitch, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull through all the loops. And next, how to make single crochet. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have two loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all two loops. And next, how to make half double crochet. To make half double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have three loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all three loops. And next, how to make double crochet. To make double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have three loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through two loops. And yarn over, pull through two loops again. And for the last stitch, how to make treble or triple crochet. To make treble or triple crochet, yarn over twice. Insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have four loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through two loops. Then yarn over, pull through two loops again. And yarn over, pull through the last two loops. And this is the basic stitches that I'll be using in this tutorial. And next, we are going to working on the bust part of the top. To begin, make a slip knot. And make the foundation chains by multiple by 2 until you got the length around your bust. But make sure to leave some space at the back part. It is for the back tie to adjust the size of the top. For my top, I make 140 chains. It is equal 22 inches length. So for this short foundation chains, it is just a sample showing you how to crochet the stitch pattern that I'll be using for this top. You just follow the description that I show in this tutorial, or you just add more chains until you got your desired fit. You can try this chain around your bust and make sure you leave some space for the back part like I show in this video. And after you got your desired length, and next we are going to work in the V-stitch pattern. To begin, continue at 3 more chains. In total, I have 143 chains. And next, for row 1, skip 4 chains. And we are going to make the V-stitch into the 5th chain. To make V-stitch, make the double crochet into the 5th chain. After you have made a double crochet, then chain 1 and make one more double crochet into the same loop. And now you must have two double crochet in the same loop with chain 1 in the middle. And next, skip 2 chains and make V-stitch into the 3rd chain. Keep repeating this until you have 3 last chains, then I will meet you back again. And after you have 3 last chains, and then skip 2 chains and make the double crochet into the last chain. And this is what the first row looks like. And next, for row 2, chain 3. For chain 3, we count as a double crochet. Then turn your work. And we are going to working the V-stitch into the chain 1 space, which is the middle part of the V-stitch. After you have made a V-stitch, then keep repeating this by make V-stitch into the chain 1 space until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the last V-stitch, then we are going to make the double crochet into the chain stitch by skip this double crochet stitch and working a double crochet into this chain stitch that we skipped at the beginning of the row. And this is what it looks like. And next, for the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 18. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 18. For the measurement from row 1 until row 18, it is equal 5 inches width. It's measuring from my under bust until it reach underneath of my underarm. For you guys that make bigger size, you can add more rows until you got your desired fit. And next, we are going to make the double crochet row beside this V-stitch edge. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is, turn your work. For row 1, chain 3 and make double crochet into this big loop. Then make a double crochet into this small loop. And next, make a double crochet into this chain stitch. After you got 3 double crochet, then skip 1 stitch and make double crochet into the next 3 stitches. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. As you can see, I made 3 double crochet and then skip 1 stitch, 3 double crochet and skip 1 stitch. Next, for row 2, chain 3, turn your work, skip 1 stitch that needs chain 3 and make double crochet into every stitch until you reach the end of the row, then we meet you back again. For the last stitch, make sure you work in double crochet into this chain 3 stitch. And this is what the second row looks like. And next, turn your work. We are going to continue make the picot stitch at this upper edge. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is and chain 1. And make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. Then make single crochet into the next big loop and make single crochet into the next small loop and make one more single crochet into this big loop, which is the chain stitch. And after you got 4 single crochet, then chain 3. After you got 3 chains, then skip 2 chains and make slip stitch into the first chain, that near single crochet stitch. After you have made slip stitch, then continue make single crochet into the next 4 stitches. Make sure that you work in the stitch into the double crochet stitch and into the chain space. And after you got 4 single crochet, then we are going to make the picot stitch again by chain 3 and make slip stitch into the first chain. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then we meet you back again. So for the last picot stitch, I'm gonna make slip stitch into single crochet stitch. And this is what the picot edge looks like. And next, we are going to continue make the double crochet row like this first edge by continue from where your last stitch is and chain 3. Then make 3 double crochet stitch. After you got 3 double crochet, then skip 1 stitch and repeat the same thing until you reach the end of the row. And after you reach the end of the row, you have to count the number of the stitches. Make sure that you have the same number of the stitches like the other side. And next, chain 3, turn your work, skip 1 stitch that near chain 3 and continue with the double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. And after you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. Then chain one and cut off the yarn. And this is what the bust part looks like. And next, we are going to make the ruffle part at the bottom of the top. To begin, turn your work. Then attach the yarn into the corner stitch. And next, for row 1, make single crochet into each stitch. And for this chain 2 space, you have to make 2 single crochet. And make a single crochet into this V stitch loop. Keep repeating this by make 2 single crochet into chain 2 space. And a single crochet into V stitch loop until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And next, for row 2, chain 4. Turn your work and skip one stitch near chain 4. Then make treble or triple crochet into the next 3 stitches. After you got 3 stitches of treble crochet, then we are going to make increase by make 2 treble crochet into the same loop. After you have made 2 treble crochet in the same loop, then we are going to keep repeating this by make 3 treble crochet. And then increase. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And next, for row 3, chain 4. Turn your work and skip 2 stitches, then make double crochet into the 3rd stitch. After you have made double crochet, then chain 1 and skip 1 stitch and make double crochet into the next stitch. Please keep repeating this by chain 1, skip 1 stitch and make double crochet into the next stitch until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, next for row 4, chain 4. Thank you. tighten your work and make treble crochet into the chain space. Then make treble crochet into the double crochet stitch. Keep repeating this by make treble crochet into chain space and into the double crochet stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. For the next row, please keep repeating row 3 and row 4 until you reach row 10, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 10. If you guys want your top more longer, please add more rows by repeat row 3 and row 4. And next, fold your top into 2 pieces and use stitch mark curl to mark at the middle part of it. And then try the top on your body by placing this stitch mark curl at the middle part of your chest, as you can see. And then use stitch mark curl to mark where you want to make the strap. And after you have marked where you want to make the strap, and then count the number of the stitches from the middle stitch marker until the second stitch marker. For me, I have 6 stitches of picot stitch and mark at the 7th stitch. Then you have to count the same number to the other side by count 6 picot stitch and use stitch marker to mark at the 7th stitch. So for the measurement between this both stitch marker, it is equal 8 inches length. You can try the top on your body again and use stitch marker to mark where you want to connect the back strap. And for my underarm space measurement, it is equal 4.5 inches length. And then measuring the same number to the other side by start from the 3rd stitch marker, or you can count the same number of the picot stitch like the other side, then mark it. You can fold the top into 2 pieces again to make sure that both sides are even. And next, I'm gonna show you how to make the strap. So I already made the right side, and for both sides of the strap, we repeat the same thing. It's just a little bit different. So I'm gonna show you how to make the left strap first. For the left strap, we are working from the back to the front part of the top. To begin, attach the yarn into the 4th stitch away from the stitch marker. And then make 59 chains. If you guys want your strap more longer, please add more chain. Make sure that your foundation chains is the odd number. And this is what it looks like after you got 59 chains. And for the measurement of my strap, it is equal 9 inches length. And next, we are going to connect this foundation chains into the front part of the top. Make sure that your foundation chains doesn't twist. To begin, make slip stitch into the stitch that near stitch marker. After you have made slip stitch, then make another slip stitch into the next stitch. Then turn your work, and we are going to make the mesh stitch. For row 1, make single crochet into the first chain. Then chain 1, skip 1 chain, and make single crochet into the next chain. And next, we are going to repeat this until you got 3 single crochet. By chain 1, skip 1 chain and make single crochet into the next chain. And after you got 3 single crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 chain and make half double crochet into the next chain. After you have made half double crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 chain and make half double crochet into the next chain. After you got 3 half double crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 chain and make double crochet. Keep repeating this until you got 3 double crochet. And after you got 3 double crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 chain and make treble crochet into the next chain. Keep making chain 1 and make treble crochet into the next stitch until you have 18 last chains, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you had 18 last chain. And next, chain 1, skip 1 chain and make double crochet into the next chain. Keep repeating this until you got 3 double crochet, then we meet you back again. And after you got 3 double crochet, then chain 1, skip 1 chain and make half double crochet. Keep repeating this until you got 3 half double crochet. And after you got 3 half double crochet, then chain 1 and make single crochet into the next chain. Keep repeating this until you got 3 single crochet, then I will meet you back again. And after you got 3 single crochet, and this is what the first row of the strap looks like. And next, we are going to make slip stitch into the next 2 stitches. After you have made 2 slip stitch, for row 2, turn your work. And then we are going to make the mesh stitch. By skip these 2 stitches that we make slip stitch and make single crochet into the single crochet stitch. Then chain 1 and skip chain 1 space and make single crochet into the next single crochet stitch. Keep repeating this until you got 3 single crochet, then I will meet you back again. And after you got 3 single crochet, then chain 1 and skip chain 1 space and make half double crochet into half double crochet stitch of the row below. Repeating this until you got 3 half double crochet, then I will meet you back again. And after you got 3 half double crochet, then chain 1, skip chain 1 space, and make double crochet into the double crochet stitch. Keep repeating this until you got 3 double crochet, then I will meet you back again. And after you got 3 double crochet, then chain 1, skip chain 1 space, and make treble crochet into treble crochet stitch. Keep making treble crochet until you reach double crochet stitch, then I will meet you back again. After you reach double crochet stitch, and then we are going to chain 1, skip chain 1 space, and make double crochet. Keep repeating until you got 3 double crochet. Then chain 1 and make half double crochet into half double crochet stitch. Keep repeating until you got 3 half double crochet. And then chain 1, skip chain 1 space, and make single crochet into single crochet stitch. Keep repeating until you reach the end of the row. And after you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the next 2 stitches. And for the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 4, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 4. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And now we are done making the left strap. And next, for the right strap, attach the yarn from the front part that near the stitch marker and connecting the foundation chains into the 4th stitch from the back stitch marker. Then repeat the same thing like the left strap. Remember, make sure that you're working the stitch face outside. And after you have made the strap, and next, we are going to make the small pink bow at the middle part of the top. For making this small bow, I crochet 2 strands of yarn together. To begin, attach the yarn into the stitch that near the double crochet row. And then make 100 chains. For you guys that make bigger size, you can add more chains until you reach the middle part of your top. And after you reach the middle part of your top, you can add more chains. It is for tie to make a bow. And then cut off the yarn. And next, we are going to weave in the string into the top until you reach the middle part of the top, then we meet you back again. And after until you reach the middle part of the top. Then we are going to repeat the same thing to the other side. And after you got both strings, then tie them together to make a bow. And next, for the string of the back tie, I used 2 strands of yarn and made the foundation chains long enough. Then weave in the string into the back part of the top. Then skip 3 V stitch rows and attach the string into the 4th row. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the bokeh shape row. And now your lace ruffle top is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Subscribe to my channel and don't forget to follow me on my social medias. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.